Let's say we're having a birthday party, and these are the kids at the birthday party. And all of the kids, they have a bunch of different ages. And what we are curious about is, how many kids of each age do we have? Well, to help think about that, we can draw what is called a line plot. And I've always viewed the term line plot a bit confusing, because in my brain, you use a lot more dots than you use lines. But let's look at what a line plot is. So what I will do is, I will draw, I guess this involves a line right over here. I'll draw a line down here, and then I'll create buckets for each of the ages. So let's see, I have students here from age 3 all the way to age 7. So I could say age 3, age 4, age 5, age 6, and age 7. I don't have to go to 2 or I don't have to go to 8. There aren't any kids in those ages, although I could if I want. And then I look at, well, how many kids do I have of each age? Well, I have one person attending the party, Dia. She's age 3. So I might put an X here, or I could put a dot here. Different line plots would put different things here. But that shows me that I have this partier is age 3 right over here. Now I have Imran, age 5. So that's someone. That's someone right over here who'd be age 5. You could think of this dot. This represents Imran, who's age 5. Then you have Surya, who's also age 5. So he's also age 5, so that means we have a second. We have a second person at the party who is age 5. So under age 5, we now have two people. This is Imran and this is Surya. Then you have Jasper, who is 6. So that's one person who is age 6. Then you also have Vikram, who is age 6. Whoops, let me do that in that same color. We also have Vikram, who is age 6. So let's put him in the age 6 bucket. Then we have Luke, who is 7. Luke, who is 7. So that would be a dot right over there. And then finally, I have Anya, who's also age 6. Who is also age 6. So just like that, I was able to take all of the data that I have in this table, and I'm able to put it on this line plot. And the reason why this line plot is useful is it helps us look at, well, how many of each age do we have? It might be a little bit more confusing to just look at the table here. Because when you look at the line plot, it's very clear. Hey, look, there's no one here who is age 4. And look, we have the most people who are age 6. And if we asked ourselves a question, well, how many, if you didn't even have this, actually, let me just even take it away. If we didn't even have that there, if we didn't have the table, and we just had the line plot, and if someone said, hey, look, you know, these are ages right over here. This is our ages and years old. And each dot represents a student who's at the party. So based on this line plot, how many people are more than 5 years old? Well, you could look at this and you could say, okay, more than 5 years old. That would be 6 years old or 7 years old. It's not showing anyone who's 8, 9, 10, 11, and on and on and on and on. So let's look at all the dots. Let's all look at all the dots here that are more than 5 years old. There are 3 6-year-olds and there's 1 7-year-old. So there are 1, 2, 3, 4 people who are older than 5 years old. You could go the other way around. You could say, how many people are less than 5 years old? Well, then you could say, okay, less than 5 years old would be either 3 years old or 4 years old. And when you look at those dots, you see there's only one dot. Only one person attending the party is less than 5 years old. Hopefully you found that interesting.